Hi guys, this is Sadiq from Broadband.com, and in this video, we'll show you how to launch an app via ADB command. So if you are running an emulation environment and you want to test out any app, or if you are running an Android TV, or if the touch is not working along the expected lines, or the home screen launcher is also crashing and not working, then in all those cases, this guide might come in handy. Well, in the case if the home screen launcher is not working, then in that case, what you have to do is you have to directly access the settings menu. So even if the home screen launcher is not working, you will still be able to access the QS tiles. So expand the QS tiles and then straight away go to the settings menu. And the settings menu will work without any issue even if the home screen launcher is not working. Apart from that, in case if you are running an emulation environment or debugging purpose, or if you are on Android TV, then all the things will work without any issue. But if the home screen launcher is crashing and you have installed a third party launcher such as Nova Launcher and you want to launch that app, the Nova Launcher app, and make it as a default launcher, then in those cases this might video will come in handy. In fact, I had just flashed a custom ROM and the launcher which came pre-installed was not working on that custom ROM, so I had to switch over to a different launcher. But for that I was not able to install the launcher in the first place, although I had the APK file, but I was able to install the app via the ADB install command, but I was not able to launch the Nova launcher. So this is what gave me an idea. So let's see how to launch an app via ADB commands. So with that in mind, let's get started. So once you have accessed the settings menu on your phone, so let me show you that. First and foremost, let's do so as well. And from the settings menu, you have to go to about phone and tap on build number 7 times. This will enable developer option. Once that is done, go to settings system and enable developer option, and from there enable the toggle next to USB debugging. You will then get a prompt on your phone. Tap on OK, and with this, debugging is now enabled. Let's verify the same. So go to the address bar of Platform Tools folder. You may also download the Platform Tools from my guide. I have linked that in my guide. So download and extract them onto your PC, then type in cmd in the address bar and hit enter. This will launch command prompt inside Platform Tools. Now type in ADB devices and verify that you're getting an ID. If you're not getting any ID, then unplug and replug your phone from the PC. Disable and re-enable USB debugging. Tap on revoke USB debugging. Use the official USB cable that came with your phone and use the USB 2.0 port on your PC. So carry out these USB fixes and verify that you're getting an ID. Once you're getting this ID, let's now proceed ahead. So next up, you will now have to install the app package name, or rather get hold of the app package name for the concerned app. So for the sake of reference, let's take the Google messaging app. I'm just using it for the sake of reference. So this is the Google messaging app. As you could see, let me show you. So whatever app you are dealing with, you will have to get hold of the app package name. So in case your phone screen is working, then you could simply long press on the app, select app info and get hold of the app package name. For example, it's the com Google Android apps messaging. But if the screen is not working on your phone, then you could also use the Play Store method. I've given all these methods in my guide. In case of the Play Store method, simply search for the required app and then copy the keyword after ID equals to and before the and sign. This is the and sign, so and everything before the and after ID equals to is the app package name. So in my case, it's the com Google Android apps messaging, as you could also verify from the app info page. So with this, we have got the app info. Next up comes the most important part. You will now have to get hold of the activity name of the app as well. So for that, install the activity launcher app from Play Store. In case your phone is working well and good, you could install it on your phone itself, but if it's not working along the expected line, then you will have to install this app on any other Android phone. And once you have got the activity launcher app, launch the app and now search for the app for which you want to deal. So in our case, it's the Google message app. So let's access the messaging app, and from there you will have to search for the main activity. So this is the main activity in our case. The main activity name is, as you could see, .main.mainActivity. Make sure to keep a tab on the lower and upper case as well. That's extremely important. So this is the main activity. So the entire command that we have to execute now is this AMS ADB shell AM start and package name, which we have already seen. The package name is com google android apps messaging, and then the activity name, which in our case is .main activity. So the entire command in our case will be this. As you could see over here, this is the app package name and this is the main activity name. So simply type in, so use this command syntax and paste it in notepad, and then replace the app package name and the main activity name accordingly. And once you have got everything, just type in the command in the, let me first close the app in the backend, and now let me show you. Now just type in this command, this is the app package name and this is the main activity name, and hit enter. As you could see, the Google messaging app is now launched on to our phone. But for some apps it might be the case that there will be no main activity. For example, in case of Google Photos, so let me show you Photos app, there is no main activity. If you search for main as well, so there is no main activity. So in such cases, you could take the help of the home activity as well. So as you could see right at the top, you have the home activity, because there are many activities, but all of these activities are archived. We don't have to use the archive feature. We don't have to use the live album as of now. We don't have to use the backup. What we have to do is access the home page of the app, or rather the main page of the app. Since the main page is missing, we could use the home activity as well. So the entire command syntax will be the same. Just replace the activity name with the home activity. So for instance, in case of Google Photos, the app package name is this. Let me verify it once. So go to app info page, and the app package name is com google android apps photos. So let me use this command syntax over here, and the package name is com google android apps photos. And instead of the main activity, we have the home activity, and the home activity is named as smaller home. So the h is small home, and then we have the main activity, which is the home activity. So the h is, now the h is capital and the a is capital. So as you could see, this is the home activity, and you could also open it and verify it from here as well. You could have a look at the class, and the entire class is the one which we have just typed. It's a combination of the app package name and the activity name, but let's ignore that and simply focus on this. So it's a .home activity, and this is the app package name. And now if you copy this, the entire command, and paste it in the CMD window and hit enter, it should now launch the Google Photos app. And as you could see, the app has now been launched, and you could now carry out the desired task. So guys, using this method, you could launch any app of your choice. Just keep in mind a couple of things. First off, you will have to get hold of the app package name. So if the display and the launcher is working, you could simply get hold of the app package name from your phone itself via the app info page. But if the display is not working, then you could have a look at the app package name from the Play Store as well. It's the ID equals to, and before the and sign, this is the app package name. Then comes the activity name. So by default, have a look at the main activity. And as you could see, in case of the Google messaging app, we actually had the main activity. So simply use that main activity name. But in case of Google Photos, there was no main activity, so we had to use the home activity. Moreover, the first keyword is in the lower case and the second is in the upper case. This is same for both the main as well as the home activity. So keep a tab on the upper and lower case as well. And that's just about it. This will help you launch any app of your choice using ADB command. So with that in mind, we round off this video. If you have any queries with regard to any of the steps, do let me know in the comment section. And thanks a lot for watching.